All right, welcome back. Now, I know we usually have a letter of the week, but we finished the letter W yesterday, which means what were we going to do today? Well, we're going to add one more letter to this week. And I know you're not going to have any trouble with it at all because it's lines that we have seen so much before. So, drum roll, please. What is our letter for the day? Our letter for the day is X. And I know you're not going to have any trouble whatsoever making the letter X because it's simply just two diagonal lines that cross. They make that just X. It's an X. And we see right there, where do we start our X's from? From the top, from the top, from the top, 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 from the top, from the top, from the top, 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 from the top, from the top, from the top, top, top. We start our letters from the top. And I mean, it's really easy to find things that you can make the letter X with, like your fingers. Oh, I just made an X. Look at that. You're gonna have no problem whatsoever. Now, when I show you the letter X, I've got him hiding right here. When I show him to you, I'm gonna tell you right now, there are not a whole lot of words that actually start with the letter X. X is a super duper important letter, but there aren't a ton of words that actually start with the letter X. Now, one of those words, do you know what these things here? It's not bones. It's when you look inside your body without peeling back all your skin and your muscles. Ew, gross. Are able to look with a special machine through your skin, through your muscles, to be able to see your bones inside. And that's called an X-ray. X-ray. And that's probably the most famous word that starts with the letter X. So we have X-ray. And these are all about X-rays. And why do you want to see inside your body? That's right, because you want to know what's happened to your bones. Maybe you hurt one of your bones. Maybe you need to know what's going on inside your body, and you can't like just peel your skin off and say, "Hey, look at here." No, that would hurt, and you'd have to heal, and oh, we don't want to do that. No. So we want a way to be able to look inside without actually having to be inside. And one of those things that we get to look at is your skeleton. So we're going to take a look at this book called The Book About, or A Book About Your Skeleton by Ruth Gross. Who is Ruth Gross? You're right, the author. And we know that author writes the story, author writes the story, author writes the story. That's why she comes first. Then it says Steve Bjorkman. Who is Steve Bjorkman? You're right. He is the illustrator. And we know that illustrators illustrate, illustrators illustrate, illustrators illustrate, which means he made the pictures. And we know that because we can read this special page here called the title page. Boy, you guys are smart. So smart. Okay, did you know everybody has bones? Everybody needs them. If you didn't have any bones, you would flop around like spaghetti. Can you pretend your body is spaghetti? Whoa, I have no bones. Whoa, I have no bones. I like to be able to stay up strong. I like bones. Whoa, my head. Whoa. Oh, my spine helps my head to stay still, doesn't it? Now, your bones are hard and stiff. The rest of you is soft. The hard, stiff bones help hold up the soft part, and they give the soft part a shape. So if you hold up your hand, okay, can you squish your fingers and feel your hands? You can feel those soft parts and stuff, but inside you can feel those bones, and that gives your hands, your fingers, a shape. You can feel the hard, stiff bones that help hold you up and give your body its shape. You have more than 200 bones in your body. Long bones, short bones, flat bones, curved bones, little bones, big bones. There are bones in your head and bones in your toes and bones almost everywhere in between. All of your bones put together are your skeleton. Can you say that? Skeleton. Got it? Say it one more time. Skeleton. skeleton. Good job. What a great vocabulary word. But skeleton isn't just a pile of bones. Look at that. Is that your skeleton? Well, it is a pile of bones, but it doesn't look quite right, does it? Oh, man. This isn't a skeleton. Is that how your body looks? No. And neither is this. Is that how your body looks? It's your... What? That's not what you look like inside. There we go. The bones have to be put in the right way. The bones have to be put together right. That's what you look like inside. So if they took an x-ray of your whole body, that is how you would look. That is your skeleton. So an x-ray helps us to be able to see inside of you without actually having to, like I said, peel your skin off. You. So I want to show you something before we go. All right. So here you are. Here are my students. Hello, students. How are you? And now we have an x-ray of their bones inside. So this is outside. This is my outside. And when I take an x-ray, there's your inside. Here is our outside. And here is the inside. One more time, you ready? Here is the outside. And here is the inside. Perfect. We can take an x-ray to be able to see inside. Now, I want you to make your own x-rays because, like I said, so much easier to be able to see the bones inside of you without peeling off your skin. And did you think that humans are the only ones that have a skeleton inside? Nope, you know it. There's one of a... What do you think that is? Snake? Here's one of a... Fish? Let's see what else we've got here. And I've got one of a turtle. Here's a turtle. And I've got one of a frog. I've got one of a bird. And the skeleton of a penguin. Look at what he'd look like if you x-rayed that penguin. So cool. Here is a bat. There's an x-ray of a bat. And what do you guess this might be? Can you take a guess? The x-ray of a giraffe, the skeleton of a giraffe. Wow. What about a horse? Can you see? There is that horse. And one of an elephant. Good job. And what about this guy? You know what that might be? Did you guess a cat? If you did, you're right. There's a cat. And here is one of a gorilla. A gorilla. So cool. So there are a lot of animals and people that have a skeleton, and we can take x-rays to look inside. So like I said, I want you to make your own skeleton. So I'll be right back.